Once again, good morning students. We will continue with the types of poisons which is usually ingested by children. So the first one is hydrocarbons. That is commonly ingested hydrocarbon by children is kerosene, because it is usually in all family, it is easily available in some bottles or cans. And the problem of this kerosene poisoning is with the risk of aspiration. Because when you are finding a child with the kerosene, she or he will be with violent cough. If he has consumed kerosene, definitely the child will have violent cough, and there is a chance of getting aspiration of hydrocarbon into the lung field. And in addition to that, there is EGIT and respiratory effects, burning sensation, nausea, belching, diarrhea, cough, choking, gagging and grunting. So usually 2 to 8 hours later, after the consumption, after 2 to 8 hours, we can take the chest x-ray, and usually it will demonstrate pulmonary infiltrates or perihilar densities. So that is an indication of starting of an pneumonia, because there is a chance of getting aspiration pneumonia. And usually there will be nematocells, pleural effusion or pneumothorax, and bacterial superinfection. And usually the children with this or complications will get resolution within 2 to 7 days, and if you are managing properly. So this is about the effect of kerosene poisoning in children. And the treatment, we should not induce vomiting or any gastric lavage, because we are weighing the risk of aspiration than removal of substance from the GIT. So it is better to leave the poison than induce vomiting or doing gastric lavage, because the aspiration and other complications are more severe in kerosene poisoning than the GIT effects of kerosene. So this is the weighing of benefit and complication between inducing vomiting, gastric lavage and this leaving in the GIT. And usually we do a chest x-ray after 2 to 4 hours, not before 2 hours. And we will keep the child in emergency room or PICU for 6 to 8 hours. And if there is no chest x-ray changes or there is no other symptoms, we use to discharge the child. So this is the treatment. If there is aspiration pneumonia, that should be treated properly. And within 2 to 7 days, child will be getting better prognosis. So this is about the hydrocarbon ingestion. That is the first one is kerosene poisoning. The second is organophosphorus compounds. Usually, organophosphorus compound, which is usually seen in our home, is insecticide. It may be to kill rats or any other insects which is present in our body. In our home. Inhibition of cholinesterase enzymes all over. So that is a main effect of this organophosphorus compounds. Inhibition of cholinesterase enzymes. There will be muscarinic abdominal pain, fecal incontinence can be the cholinergic effects like of respiratory secretions, crepitation and even pulmonary edema can be the CVS. There will be tachycardia, bradycardia, block and cardiac block can be there, and hypotension. Nicotinic effects like restlessness, confusion, coma, flaccidity, convulsions. So these are the effects of organophosphorus compounds, and the diagnosis is by blood cholinesterase levels. Less than 50% indicates poisoning, and usually as a test dose we will be giving atropine in case of cholinesterase inhibitions. Okay, so this is about the diagnosis. And regarding the management, ABC stabilization, airway breathing circulation is very important. Wash hair and body with soap and water, because even the smell can cause some changes in the body. Consider gastric lavage if it is within 1 hour. But an hour of ingestion, we can give gastric lavage. Atropine sulfate IV till pupils are normal size. And the dose is 0.02 milligram per kilogram. And it is given, will be given for 15 to 20 minutes. Then atropine sulfate IV till pupils are normal size. And remember, atropine has no effect on muscle paralysis, must support breathe. So there is no effect on paralysis, that's why you have to give to prevent the respiratory paralysis and the stopping of respiration, we have to support breathing with oxygen or any other measures. Then use cholinesterase reactivator such as pralidoxim. The dose is 1 gram per kilogram IV and it should be given within 30 minutes. Next poison is, already we have seen two poisons, that is organophosphorus compounds and the kerosene poisoning. The next one is carbon monoxide poisoning. Carbon monoxide is a colorless and odorless gas that is created when burning a fuel, that is such as gasoline, propane, natural gas, oil, wood or charcoal. So usually it can be occur in improperly ventilated stoves and fireplaces, as well as running cars can lead to buildup of carbon monoxide gas, and it is can occur in enclosed or semi-enclosed spaces. So there should be proper ventilation when we are burning any fuel or when we are using car or any other fuel burning area, there should be proper ventilation, and if it is not there, it can lead to carbon monoxide poisoning. Because of their high metabolic rates and high tissue oxygen demands, children are biologically at increased risk of carbon monoxide poisoning when exposed to carbon monoxide. Next is, common symptoms include headache, dizziness, fatigue, nausea, vomiting and confusion. And it may lead to coma and death in many children. And carbon monoxide poisoning can often be mistaken for flu or food poisoning. If carbon monoxide leak, more than one person may have the symptoms. So not only children, the other people who is exposed with the carbon monoxide poisoning also can have the manifestation. So that is another effect of carbon monoxide poisoning. Next, we can see the management. Attention to the ABCDs of resuscitation is the mainstay of emergency care for the patient with the carbon monoxide intoxication. And all patients with a suspected or confirmed carbon monoxide exposure should be given 100% oxygen until they are asymptomatic and the carboxyhemoglobin concentration is below 10%. So as it is primarily affecting the respiratory system, have to give the management for airway breathing and circulation properly, and we have to give oxygen administration till the manifestations or the symptoms are settling. So this is about the management, and very importantly, the next is poisoning prevention. So this topic is already discussed in the accidents and other topics which we already discussed in the previous classes. Poisoning, so storage of poisons materials in the home, and these important points should be informed to the parents, because usually the poisoning in children is happening in the home environment. So this is for today's topic, and thank you very much for kindly listening to the topic. Thank you very much.